Welcome to another journey into the power of the harvest with Pastor Charles Ellis. Power of the Harvest offers biblical answers to today's questions, all found in the Word of God. Allow Pastor Ellis to guide you through the Word as he teaches with clarity and transparency so that you can not only understand, but begin practicing the Word of God so your life can be forever changed. Now, listen to today's teaching on the power of the harvest with Pastor Charles Ellis. Church, but what am I looking for?
Harvest New Life.
A place where the Word teaches, not preaches.
Harvest New Life.
A place where there is transparency, not just kindness.
Harvest New Life.
A place where friendship grows into relationship.
Harvest New Life.
A place where everyone grows together, understanding, discipling, and ministering to everyone in the Lord.
Metro, Dallas, and Fort Worth.
The ministry you've been looking for is right here, right now.
Harvest
New Life Church, 701 East Campbell Road, Richardson, Texas, invites you on a journey of the Word of God in teaching, realness of the Word in its transparency by Pastor Charles Ellis, the opportunity to learn evangelism and the power of God moves in a ways that you may not have ever experienced before. Come join us in worship every second and fourth Sunday. Bible study at 9:15 a.m. Log on to our website at www.harvestnewlifechurch.com. Or for more information, call us at 214-870-2146. That's 214-870-2146. Searching is over. Come in, and we'll meet you right where you are. Healing begins now.
Harvest New Life.
Harvest New Life Church.
Bless your name forever. Amen. God bless you. It's Morgan and Tony this morning. It's New Life Church and Harvest New Life Studio. We're going to be right back into the teaching. And we've been dealing with the area of the Antichrist. This is going to be series four, whatever you want to call it, volume. There's going to be a few volumes, a few books I'm going to be writing on terms of these services that I do. They'll be available to you as you go to my website. But once again, we thank you for being with us on this morning. It's always a pleasure to be in the midst of each and every one of you as God continues to bring forth the word. To do the work that he's called me to do in the season of which I'm in. And I'm just so thrilled with the opportunity to know that even just celebrating a new birthday on yesterday, for most of you who know me, knew my birthday. It's not according to what you see on the Facebook. But if you know me personally, then you know my birthday. But for those of you who don't know, my birthday actually took place on yesterday. And I had a great celebration of time with my family and my daughter. And I want to commend her for giving me that surprise. And it was just a great time to know that there's no physical structure in my body or anything to the point of there's any kind of what they call dilemma of hindrances. I thank God for giving me a free bill of health. Ready to move forth and do the work that God's called me to do. But we got to move forth on this word today, dealing with the book of Thessalonians. We're going to be talking about the area of the Antichrist. As I said always before when it comes to the show, I'm going to let the music just solidify itself just a bit. Let it marinate into your system and get your mind regulated to understand what we're about to bring forth. And it's going to be a revelatory word that comes from the kingdom. And even as the music begins to play, I want you guys to just sit back and realize and understand there's a presence of the power of the Spirit. Is about the move and the work that we're doing in the season between in. You know, the word of God says there's not one weapon formed against us, prosper. It does says nothing we will withstand, but you're going to have to believe and declare that according to Mark 9:23, that him that believe, all things are possible. So we want you to just sit back. We're going to get into this word in just a few minutes, and we're going to see what the word of God has to say that's coming from the kingdom of God. Amen. God bless you and God keep you.
Some of that scripture, boys and girls, we've been learning this together. We can trust him at all times. Let's sing it. Delivered me from fear.
He has delivered me from all fear.
Set my feet on a rock.
He has set my feet upon a rock. And I will not be
oh.
Father God, I thank you. I bless you this morning, Father God. And even as we come before you, Father God, we ask you to just illuminate. Let the power of your spirit begin to transform and let it change. Father God, even as we all bow our heads before you, Father God, as we come before your throne, we receive that which you have given us to come from the kingdom of God. And Lord, we declare right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that even as you begin to give us the strength that we need, Father God, as we continue to pray to you, Father God, and have the understanding to realize, Father God, that you are God of an authority. You are God of authority. You are God of change. You are God of transformation. And Father God, even in the midst of me praying, Father God, that's not the first prayer to my mother. And I'm asking you, Father God, to look up on her, Father God, as she lays what seems to be home in a bed of affliction in the name of Jesus. But your word is decreed and declared according to the kingdom of God. Lord, there's nothing. And I don't take that word lightly. There's nothing too hard for you to do. He said that everything we need is in the kingdom. So, Father God, I declare by the word of God that even as we speak, Father God, according to Isaiah 53 and 5, that you were wounded. The translation says that you was wounded for our transgressions.